everyone, and welcome to my very first Create a Sim video. I am super, super excited for this video, and I'm actually gonna save a lot of the talking for the video because I have a feeling I'm going to be needing to fill in space as the video is going on. So this is going to be of Lady Ava, who is about to become the Queen of Windenburg. In our next episode of The Royal Family, we will be having the royal wedding, so she will become the queen then, so I wanted to make sure I had her outfits picked out. So let's go ahead and start the video. Okay, so here we have Lady Ava. So this is the outfit that she is already in. It was very cute. I just didn't think it was very fitting for a queen, especially with her hair and that dress. She just looked like really young, which she is. She's a young adult, so she is a little bit younger than King Henry, which is fine, but I just wanted to make her look a little bit more mature, a little bit more like respectable and like a queen, of course. So I definitely wanted to change her outfits and hair and everything. Also, I apologize if you guys hear some buzzing in the background. They are mowing the lawn as I'm recording this, so they actually stopped right now, but they keep going and doing it again, so just so you're aware. But yeah, in this video, you'll be able to see a bunch of the CC items that I have and that I have downloaded. So I actually end up going with this dress. I do pick two different outfits for her everyday outfit and for some of the other outfits. I think I picked three for the formal outfit because I wanted one of them to be her wedding gown as well. So I definitely wanted to find an updo that I thought was fitting for her. And I love her hair like that though, just like the messy kind of like half up, half down that she had. But I do definitely think that she needed to have her hair up, so I ended up going with that. But yeah, so I end up going with this bun for like most of her outfits because a lot of the royals and nobles, I have like a specific hairstyle that they typically wear. So just because sometimes they can change their hairstyle and stuff and it would be okay, but I wanted it to be like specific, like their signature hairstyle kind of thing. And that flower beret, that white one that you saw, I ended up not going with it because it was clipping the side of her hair, which I didn't love so much. So I ended up just not going with it, but I thought that would have been really cute. So I'd like to find another cute beret hair clip thing that she could wear that would go with her outfits as well. But yeah, so for the Create a Sim videos, I'm thinking of launching for my Patreon. So this would be a bonus that some of the members would get, would be like my Create a Sim videos. Probably wouldn't have a face cam for the ones that are just for my members on Patreon, but for the ones that are like early release, like if I did another thing like this, then I would definitely release that to my members on Patreon first, and then I would maybe post them on YouTube a little bit later. So yeah, just so you guys know. So I will give out some more information about my Patreon later on because I am going to be launching it soon. I'm probably thinking maybe like after July 4th, so maybe like July 6th or maybe before July 4th. I will definitely let you guys know as soon as possible, but I definitely do want to launch that soon. So you guys can please like let me know the other membership perks that you would like to see if you were to become a member, because I would love to know. I've been working on it though, and it's like almost finished, but I would still love to know any other suggestions that I can add as well. But yeah, so for this is her formal outfit. So this is like one of her main ball gowns, and I love the big ball gowns for the queens and everything too. And I did not want it to be the same ball gown that Queen Alice had. So Queen Alice's ball gown was a little bit more like a deep purple, and then it didn't have like the side sleeve thing. I don't know what that's called, the off shoulder thing. It had like these lace sleeves for her. So I ended up going with that though for Lady Ava. And then for her wedding dress, I think you guys actually missed it, which is fine because I kind of want it to be a surprise. Oh gosh, and that ball gown right there is totally like Belle from Beauty and the Beast because it comes with yellow. But I was like, oh my gosh, it is way bigger than it needed to be. I think if that ball gown was just like a little bit smaller, then it would be perfect. But I think it was just a little bit too much, so I wasn't too sure about it. But I did definitely want to have like another formal gown for her to wear as well. But the wedding dress, because I think it was a little bit too quick for you guys to see now, but you guys will get to see that at the wedding, and I love it. It's beautiful. You guys probably saw a little sneak peek, and you could probably also just go back a little bit and pause it, but oh my gosh, it's so pretty. It has like these lace like ribbons around her arm for the sleeves. I do love this one that we ended up going with for the other formal outfit as well, because it still has that big ball gown feel, and it has like that deep purple to it, which was the royal family colors of Windenburg colors. They have purple. It was supposed to be purple, but I was so limited, and this was before I had custom content, I was so limited to the purple outfits that we had that I was like, you know what, it needs to be like purple and pink. So then I started making the other royal families have like multiple colors, except for the Willow Creek royal family, because theirs is just blue, but there's like so many shades of blue that I was like, it can just be blue, that's fine. But for Oasis Springs, we have like green and yellow, and then for Bridgerton Bay, it's like red and orange, and then for the royal royal family of Sulani. They don't really have royal colors because that's not really their custom to do that. So I didn't end up going with any royal colors for them, which I like though, because it's not like super limiting. But then for the other families, it's just kind of nice to have as like their own thing. Like they're representing their family and their country or their kingdom. So it's like kingdom spirit, like kind of like school spirit, but kingdom spirit. So I did end up going with this one for her party outfit as well. So for this, I personally love off the shoulder dresses. Like those were my go-to dresses for like prom dresses or for my pageant gowns or something like that. I would just love off the shoulder dresses so much. I really wanted to do a crown for her, but all those small tiaras just kind of looked too much like a princess crown to me. So I didn't like that so much. And then I loved that hairstyle, but I couldn't go with like the crown for her hairstyle too. And I did also make sure that her crown was not the same as Queen Alice's. Although I guess it would make sense for it to be the same, but I think Queen Alice's crown will probably be passed down to the next queen, which would be whoever King Kellan or Prince Kellan ends up marrying when he becomes king too. So yeah, but you guys can just see kind of like the different outfits. I think you guys like slightly saw the wedding gown I have in mind for Princess Nea for her wedding. So I think you guys saw that it was like the one that's very like Middle Eastern Indian style, but like it has like a big ball gown with it too. And it comes in like many different colors. And oh my gosh, I'm so excited for when she gets married, because I have had that gown for like since she was a kid, I think, and it's been so long. So oh gosh, guys, I'm so excited for when we do all of their weddings though. Like I'm very excited to make all of their weddings a little bit different too. So it'll be super exciting. But I also ended up picking up some like warm weather and cold weather outfits for her as well. I end up like taking off the hot weather and the cold weather like picking selection thing because it's just so limiting, and like they could totally wear some of the other stuff. And just for the hot weather and cold weather, especially hot weather, just some of the stuff is like a tank top or like shirtless or something like that, especially for the guys. So it's like, well, I don't want my royals to wear that, so I just take off that filter anyway. But I love that dress too. I it just passed, but like the one that was like kind of frilly and sheer, oh my gosh, I love that one too. I think that one might be a little bit more for princess dresses, and we could probably pick out some more of Princess Amira and Princess May's outfits too, because I feel like they're due for an outfit change at some point as well. But I think we can do that a little bit later. I did end up going with this for hot weather outfit, and it may be a little bit too much coverage for warm weather, but again, it's that off the shoulder dress, but it's still kind of casual enough. I just didn't think that one specifically was good enough for a party outfit, or especially for a formal outfit. Just like the material of it didn't look like it would be, so I just ended up going with it for her warm weather outfit. That's what I like, is like being able to pick different ones. But guys, I'm so excited for her to become the queen. I think this video is like, yeah, so I have like a minute left of the video, but oh my gosh, I'm so excited. I definitely would like to keep continuing doing cast videos, because they're actually a lot of fun, and this like doesn't require that much editing because I can just talk as I'm watching the video too, which is pretty cool. So I would definitely love to do this with future Sims, maybe featuring some other noble Sims as well, anyone who I think really needs a makeover, and that way you guys can kind of get to know some of the other nobles as well, because I know we don't get to talk about them. But for my Patreon, when I reach my goal, so I will explain all this again later on, but when I reach my goal on Patreon, it's like a monthly goal that you can set. So I think I'm going to start a mini series for the nobles, so you guys can let me know what you think of that, because it would be nice to tell the story of the nobles a little bit more and kind of get to know them and see like if there's any other scandals or anything going on with them too, because we kind of get to see some of the nobles, but not a lot of them unless they like end up marrying one of our royals or something like that, or having a thing with one of our royals. So yeah, you guys can let me know what you think of that. But I did add the gloves for her too, because I just thought the gloves just made it look much more elegant than it already was. It's already so elegant, but I like that it just adds a little bit more to it. So I ended up going back and adding a bunch of gloves and then taking a bunch of screenshots. So yeah, guys, so that's pretty much it for Lady Ava, soon to be Queen Ava, or Queen Evangeline, I think we're gonna go with for her. So yeah, you guys can let me know what you think of her outfits. Let me know what you thought of this cast video, because it's definitely a new thing for me. But I hope you guys enjoy this. I hope you guys like her new outfits. If you haven't already, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on your notifications. If you enjoyed this and if you like her outfits and if you want me to keep doing more Create a Sim videos, give this video a big thumbs up and hit that like button, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!